हेलो गाइस, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सीएसआईआर नेट 2017 जून केमिस्ट्री क्वेश्चन बुकलेट ए, क्वेश्चन नंबर 46. सो इट इज अ 2 मार्क्स क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन योर स्क्रीन, प्लीज नोट डाउन द क्वेश्चन. सो नाउ वील गो फॉर द डिटेल्स मेकानिज्म. सो दिस इज एन ब्रोमो सक्सेनामाइड इज गिवेन. सो दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एन ब्रोमो सक्सेनामाइड. सो बिफोर गोइंग द डिटेल्स मेकानिस्टिक एनालिसिस ऑफ दिस रिएक्शन, आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस this n-bromosuccinamide reactivity pattern. Generally, n-bromosuccinamide used to give with the H-nu condition or AIBN and heating condition. AIBN means azo isobutyl nitrile. Okay? So, n-bromosuccinamide generally used to do the allylic or benzylic bromination. So, if n-bromosuccinamide used to given in this, in H-nu or some other condition, then it will form this one. Okay, so this is the allylic bromination will happen. But we know generally in this case, if we give bromine ion, bromine Br2, then what will happen? It will form the bromonium ion, and then a Br minus will react in this. It will go, so it will form this one, Br CH2. So this will form. So n-bromosuccinamide is specifically formed the allylic brominating product. Now, this n-bromosuccinamide actually contains a small amount of Br2. Okay, small amount of Br2 is contains this n-bromosuccinamide, which is needed for the initiating the reaction. Now, if it is given AIBN or H-nu, so what AIBN actually structure is this? So N double bond N, CH3 CH3 CN CN. Okay, so when heat used to give, then it will go for this type of cleavage, and N2 will produce and one radical will produce. Okay, now this radical can react with the small amount of bromine present in the NBS, and it can form the Br dot. Okay, and the H-nu condition also do use to same, it will also form the Br dot. Okay, so this Br dot, whatever is produced here, that will react with the allylic hydrogen. Okay, it will take this allylic hydrogen and it will produce a allylic radical. So allylic radical is very stable because it has a resonating structure. Okay, so it can go for a resonance. But if this radical will react here, then the radical will form here. That is, there is no resonance stability, and hence that radical is not so stable. So it will go for specifically forming the allylic radical. So this allylic radical, so see, this bromine dot will take this proton and it will form the HBr. Now this HBr will react with N-bromosuccinamide. So this is the structure of N-bromosuccinamide. And what will happen? This HBr, this lone pair will take the proton from here and the Br minus will remove, and it will form this one. Okay, and this will come here and it will take proton like this. So this is the OH double bond N Br plus and double bond O, and the Br minus will come out from here. This Br minus will react to here and it will form a bromine molecule, Br2 molecule, and at the same time it will form this one as well. This automatic structure of this. Okay, so this Br2 will again go for the cleavage with either H-nu condition, or it can cleave by this radical what is previously formed. So in that way the reaction will propagate. So this is the initiation and then it will propagate the reaction. Okay, so now I will come to today's example. Okay, so this is the today's reaction. Now we can see that the bromine radical what is generating, this bromine radical can take the proton from the allylic position. So because or benzylic position, because this bromine NBS used to react in that way. So it will form the radical here. So there is a radical will form. Now the Br2 molecule which come out from the NBS, so this Br2 molecule can react like this and it will come, can go like this. So one more Br dot will produce. So what is the structure? It will form this one. So one bromination will happen here. Now one more Br dot. See, this Br dot can react with this hydrogen or this hydrogen. So there are two benzylic hydrogen, right? So now this Br dot will react this hydrogen or this hydrogen. If it is react with this hydrogen, then the radical will form here. Now we know bromine has a minus I effect, means electron pulling effect. Okay, so this electron pulling effect will make the carbon radical unstable, because carbon radical is a electron deficient species. It does not have octet, so it has a electron deficient species, and minus I will destabilize the system. Okay, and bromine does not have so much resonance effect, because the bromine orbital size and the carbon orbital size is not matching, because it has a 4p orbital, carbon has 2p orbital, so 4p is much bigger size, so it does not have that much resonating stability. It has only minus I effect, and that will make unstable the radical, and hence this radical will not form there, it will form here. So the radical will form here. So this will be the radical form, and then it will again react with this bromine molecule, and it will form one more Br dot, and it will form this compound. So bromine and bromine. So this is the product. Okay, so this is our final product. So now you can see here this two bromination happen in this two different carbon. Okay, and here the same carbon, and here in the benzene ring. So these two obviously will overruled, and these two has the competition, but we know the radical will produce in two different carbon, not in the same carbon. So therefore this is the correct answer. So hope guys you understand the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe this channel. I will come for the next video tomorrow. Thank you so much.